Hello everyone, I'm going to be walking through how you can use Meshroom, which is a free open source photogrammetry software, to process your photographs into a 3D textured model. So just to start, this is what Meshroom looks like. It's pretty simple to use. You can just drag in your image files here. You'll have an image viewer to look closely at the photographs, a 3D viewer to look at any 3D data that's generated. And then down here, we have the sort of pipeline flow, which each step represented as a node. And what's really nice about this is it's just set up to sort of the basic setup that you need for any basic photogrammetry that you're doing. So you do not really have to do any tweaking of this, at least when you're starting out. So to get started, I'm going to load in my basic photographs of Diabloceratops that I've taken. And right away, one thing you'll notice is in the upper left corner of each photograph, there's this yellow camera shutter. And what this is saying is that the program is not able to get direct metadata from these photographs. That's because they were taken on a phone camera, which doesn't necessarily record that metadata in the same way as a DSLR. But the program is at least able to approximate the necessary metadata, so it's still very usable. If you use a DSLR, that's a little better because you do directly get that metadata, and these camera shutters should show up as green. So once you've loaded in your data, it might be tempting just to hit this big green start button at the top, but because this is a process that takes so long, you don't want to do it all at once. You want to go to an intermediate step to make sure that your data is turning out the way you want it to. So first you'll want to start by, of course, saving your project. And this is the type of project that saves as a sort of a cache or set of folders. So going into this project that I've already run, this is what the whole folder looks like, with this MG being the project file I would open up, and then the cache, which has all of the data that's exported from each step. Once you've saved your project, the step you will want to go to first is structure from motion. So these first set of steps are basically doing what we talked about before, where they're matching up different elements in the different photographs and trying to see which components of which photographs match up with each other. Don't need to worry too much about the specifics of that. And then the structure from motion basically computes what the three-dimensional structure of the object is based on the quote-unquote motion of the camera, so the changing camera positions that you've done. So all you need to do is right-click and hit compute. And then you'll have to wait a while because it does take quite a bit of time depending on the data that you're using. Once this step is done, you should get a point cloud that will allow you to examine if your photographs are generating the model correctly. All right, so this is what it looks like when the structure from motion step has finished. You should get a point cloud showing up in your 3D viewer. And you can inspect this to make sure that the 3D structure has been reconstructed correctly. So when I look at this, the entire room is being reconstructed since it was part of the background of the photographs, but I do have the density of points concentrated right at the Diabloceratops cast that I was focusing on. I can examine this. I can see there might be one or two stray points, but that's fine. Most of them are sort of matching up with the color and shape that I would expect for the object that I was looking at. Another thing you can examine too is if the cameras or the photographs are in the right position. So for this Diabloceratops, I did three rings of photographs at different levels around it, and you can see the positions of these little rectangles representing those are matching up nicely with what I did. And I could even zoom out and look and see, oh, there might be a few stray points out there, but that's fine. I don't see any stray photograph cameras. So that means that everything is being matched up correctly. And these photographs should generate a good 3D model. Real quick, I am doing just scroll wheel to zoom in and out, holding down scroll wheel to pan, and then holding down left click to rotate. So once you have checked and made sure your structure for motion is generating a point cloud that looks good, you can just hop and finish up the rest of the steps by right-clicking on texturing and clicking compute. It's already run in this case, but you would be able to do that in order to generate the mesh and texture and everything else you need. You might, however, notice that there's a lot of sort of extra gunk in the form of the room data in this file. And in that case, I might want to crop it. Now, Meshroom, at least as far as I know, doesn't have a way for you to crop the point cloud in software, but you can take the point cloud data out of the software, import it into something like Blender, and crop it in there. And you can do this in the same way you would really get anything out of Meshroom, by going to the cache and the project file. So this is my project again, this is the cache. And then I would go down to Structure from Motion and take this FSM or Structure from Motion point cloud file. Once you're done with the texturing step, mesh won't actually show up in here, but you can inspect it by just, again, going to the cache and going to that texturing step, and then opening up your .obj that mesh room is generating. Now, if you are exporting these files, you want to keep the texture with them. It is important to note these textured meshes are multiple files. So they're the image of the textures themselves that will get mapped over. These look kind of wacky if you just look at them by themselves, but this is able to be mapped over the entire mesh. You also have this MTL file that's telling these images how they map over the mesh, and then finally the mesh itself. And if I want to go and inspect this, I can see, again, there's not a lot of detail in the room because I wasn't focusing on the room, but it still got into the background. But there is a nice, surprisingly good for how low resolution my phone is, 3D model of Diabloceratops here. You'll see the bottom of it isn't super well reconstructed, but that's because I wasn't really taking pictures of that bottom part. But everything else looks good. So I could export that into Blender and crop it. I could use it as is. If I wanted to scale it so that I had the actual scale, I might go and measure the physical specimen and then scale it in Blender or Mesh Lab, something like that. But that's the basics of how you can generate your 3D model from your photogrammetry data.